with internet today, it's much easier than it was 30, 40 years ago to do literature search. So there are a number of scientific sources, databases, PubMed and so on, Medline. But, you know, one of the things that you have to be really cautious of is that the scientific literature is littered with bad data, poorly designed studies, and wrong conclusions. And at least 50% of the papers are not worth the paper they're written on. So I really read scientific literature with a skeptic's eye and question everything. Even if I find an interesting article, I might actually replicate their experiment to validate whether what they're saying is true or not. And so don't believe everything you read in scientific literature. Sometimes you have to talk to a broad cross-section of people and read a lot of literature to see if there are conflicting reports on a particular topic. So I really like to prepare myself. So I before I talk to a bunch of physicians who are experts in that field, I'll actually scan the literature. I'll know what has been done, what has been tried, where the complications are, where the issues are, and the outcomes of different therapies. And then I'll sit down and get their perspective. So I have a list of questions to ask. And I don't believe everything they say because they're speaking from their personal experience. But I'm listening to them. I might challenge them in some cases. I think it's a learning experience for me in these conversations. And it might trigger me to go back and learn something that they mentioned about that I hadn't covered. So it's a really valuable interaction, but you have to go prepared. You can't just sort of go and ask a physician, so what are your problems in this field? You're not going to get a very useful answer.